of Jesus. I thank you for my brothers and sisters, Lord God, and to our name of Jesus. Lord, Father, we ask for our sisters and brothers that we follow him. Father God, we thank you that we preach brothers, pastors, Bishop Tongs, Pastor Jimmy Jones. Amen.
Hello, my brothers and sisters. Welcome again, once again, to Saving Souls and Making Disciples, where I am your host, E.V. Davis Jr. Amen. Pastor E.V. Davis Jr. Amen. E.V. Davis Jr. You could call me Pookie if you want to. Amen. Praise God, because a lot of y'all still do. Amen. We thank God for you tuning in to the show when you do. Amen. We promise that, we're not going to be so far in between, because I got a family, and you know how family things get you down. Not get you down, but you know how they had you moving. Amen. So we're not gonna deal you with all the things that's going on, but we do want you to know that we do welcome you to tuning in, where we read precept upon precept and line upon line. Just 1 minute. Hang on, just 1 minute. Right there. We're back. Amen. And we just thank you once again for tuning in. Amen. If you have your Bibles, amen, come and go with us, amen, to the book of John, St. John, chapter 6. Amen. Chapter 6. We're going back into chapter 6 of St. John. Amen. And we're starting where, amen, we're talking about, amen, the bread of life. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we just want to just continue to lift up the word of God wherever possible. Amen. We do thank God for just being God and God all by himself. Amen. Because God is he's the Alpha and the Omega. Amen. He's the beginning and the end. Amen. Without this God, we serve a true and living God. Amen. This is not for shape, form, or fashion, but we promise you that we do come from, amen, the Word of God. We read it precept upon precept and line upon line. Amen. Amen. Once again, my aim and objective is to, amen, save a soul. Amen. From the burning hell fire. Amen. And to make a disciple, one that will just go out and tell somebody, amen, about that somebody, amen, that knows everybody. Amen. Jesus, amen, the Son of the Living God. Amen. That this is my aim and this is my objective. Amen. So we hope that you are going to tell somebody about the goodness of God. Amen. We're going to begin reading, amen, at the 23rd verse of St. John chapter 6. It says, our Father did eat manna. Amen. Oh, let's see here. Let me see. I think we better go up just a little bit. Let's start at verse 23. Howbeit there, another boat from Tiberias. Yeah, this is when Jesus was walking on the water, amen, was coming, amen. And when the people therefore saw that Jesus was not there, neither his disciples, they also took shipping and came to Capernaum, seeking for Jesus, amen. It said, when they had followed him on the other side of the sea, they said unto him, Rabbi, when camest thou hither? Hallelujah. When camest thou hither? And Jesus answered it and said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, ye seek me not because ye saw the miracles, but because ye did not eat of the loaves and were filled. Labor not for the meat which perishes, but for the meat which endureth unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give unto you, for he hath God the Father sealed. He hath God the Father sealed. When you accept Jesus Christ into your heart and into your mind, the deal is sealed. Hallelujah. Because you then not only tap in, amen, to Jesus and the Holy Spirit, but you tap in to God the Father. Because if you can remember, as you know, as we're going forward, understand that it says in John chapter 14, verse 6, he said, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man cometh to the Father except by me. Amen. So once you tap into Jesus, you then receive the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. Amen. And then those three are connected, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. That goes on to read about, it tells about that you didn't come because you seen the miracles, because you didn't eat of the bread. Because you weren't part of that miracle, you want to be part of another one. Amen? So by you tuning in today, that means you're looking for a miracle. Amen. So what we're going to do, we're going to continue to read here what Jesus says. Amen. A lot of folk, amen, are sometimes looking for the wrong thing in the wrong place. Amen. But as you see the magnitude of people, amen, they followed Jesus, amen. And when they couldn't find him, they sought him. They seeked after him. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things will be added unto you. When you seek God with your whole heart, when you seek Jesus with your whole heart, amen, those miracles that you're asking for are on the way. Praise the Lord. Listen what it says here. It says, then said they unto him, what shall we do that we might work the work of God? And Jesus answered and said unto them, this is the work of God, that ye believe on him whom he has sent. See, some people think that we got to work in order to get this thing. Hallelujah. We know that faith without works is dead, but the gift of God and salvation is free. It's free. The only thing that you got to do in order to receive this and to be a worker of God is to receive Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. I just pray for Chester's family. Hallelujah out there. Amen. We knew Chester for a long time. But we're just praying that Chester, amen, continue to seek Jesus even in the bad times. And if I know Chester, just like I knew little Gus, he cried out to Jesus often and told Jesus, have mercy on me according to thy loving kindness and thy tender mercy. We thank God that we had the little time we did with Chester. We thank God that we were able to see a man, Chester, live out his life to thus far. But how many know that, amen, that one day you got to go that way? Hallelujah. One day you got to go that way because God, amen, said that once a man to live, once a man to die. The Bible says there's a time to live, amen, and there's a time surely to die. Job said it like this. He said, once a man that is born of a woman is only but a few days, but full of trouble. Hallelujah. But let not your heart be troubled. For if you believe in God, believe also in him. Who is him? Jesus. It said, for he's going away to prepare a place for you. Amen. And it's coming back, amen, to receive you unto itself. Amen. He said, where I am, ye shall be also. Hallelujah. I ain't going to preach nothing today, but I am going to tell you the word of God and what it says. It goes on to say here, it says, our fathers ate manna in the desert. As it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave not the bread from heaven, but my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven. Hallelujah. How many know that Jesus, hey, hallelujah, is the true bread? Hallelujah. He said, if you eat of me, amen, you won't have to be hungry no more. Hallelujah. If you eat of me, you won't have to be thirsty no more. Hallelujah. And if you eat of me right, amen, those things that you're doing, amen, that opposes to God's nature will then fall off. Hallelujah. They will fall off, amen, and never, amen, to return. But I'm here to tell you that sometime, amen, they come back and they knock on your door. Hallelujah. And if your house is swept clean, amen, then it will come in and tear your whole house up. Praise God. Praise God. This is not about, amen, amen, the materialistic thing, amen, that most men look for, amen, in God. Every time you mention God, you always got your hand out. Amen. Hallelujah. But how many of you, amen, want the true bread? The true bread, which is Jesus. Look what it say here. It said, for the bread of God is the, you know, say, for the bread of God is he which cometh down from heaven and giveth life unto the world. It is he that came down, amen, wrapped in swaddling clothes. Hallelujah. His name was Jesus. It's not about, amen, being a Nubian, hallelujah, with all the scientific and philosophies and genealogies. Amen. It's not about Hebrew Israelite. Hallelujah. Nah, it's all about black, amen, and black power. Amen. We know, I know, hallelujah, that I'm chosen before the foundation of the world. Anyway, how many know, amen, in God there is no color. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. We must know, amen, that there's the bread of life that came down, amen, to save the world. He came down to save you. Yes, you. The one that's watching that my show right now. It ain't my show, it's God's show. But you know, our show. Let me just say our show. Hallelujah. Because I take no credit. I take no credit, amen, from where I come from to where I am today. I give all the credit to God through Jesus. Because he showed me with my very own eyes. How many of you know Shorty Cahee? Hallelujah. Robert Cahee. Hallelujah. I remember going up to the hospital, amen, after he had been run over by an Astro van. Amen. He was a little tipsy, amen, one night, and by chance, amen, a little accident happened where he got ran over by an Astro van. How many know that an Astro van is heavy? Hallelujah. How many know that steel don't move? Hallelujah. And that crown didn't give. Amen. When I walked into, amen, the situation, Robert was, didn't look like Robert. Amen. He, amen, was swole up, amen, real big. Hallelujah. I can just say it like that. He was swollen. His body was swollen. And the thing was going up, and it was coming down. Hallelujah. Yes, he was on a respirator. How many know that you need a respirator? I need a respirator. Hallelujah. I needed a respirator. But my respirator was Jesus. Hallelujah. I began to tell his sister, amen, not Angie, but, and excuse me, I cannot call your name right now, but you know, y'all know the show, y'all know who I'm talking about, amen, the baby sister, amen. Me and her was in this room, and we began to pray. Hallelujah. As it looked kind of dim to a lot of people on the outskirts that looking for the material things, looking for the for God to move because they wanted him to move. But how many know that a spiritual, it had to be a spiritual awakening that Robert had to hear? Well, anyway, right now today, after praying and laying hands on my brother, speaking into his spirit, they said 30 minutes after I left, he came out the coma. Hallelujah. And I give no credit, but that's the things that I know that the breath, the bread of life have showed to me. He showed me that, amen, he can give you power and authority. Let me show it to you over here in Luke. Luke chapter 15, I believe it is. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. It said Mark chapter 15. Mark chapter 15. Amen. Mark chapter 15. And he said these words. And he said unto them, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. And he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. But he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. Listen at this now. In my name shall they cast out devils and shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly drink, it shall not harm them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. That's in the Bible. Go to Mark chapter 16. Mark chapter 16 and 15. Read it for yourself. It's in there. But I'm letting you know that the bread of life, he will show you things that you've never seen before. I got about 3 or 4 more minutes. But I'm going to read just a little bit more. Then said they unto him, Lord, evermore give us this bread. So when Jesus speaks, people listen. Amen. When Jesus speaks, people listen. Here were the people that believed that the meat that fell from heaven was the meat that was going to carry them into the eternal life. Hallelujah. But God sent the real meat. John chapter 1 tells us that he came in the form of man. Put on man's body. And men seen him walk this nation, walk the areas of which he walked, healing the sick, delivering the blind, and causing the lame to walk. This is the man that I'm talking about. And this is what these Jews seen and Gentiles seen in Jesus. And they said, give us that bread. How many of you want that bread right now? Hallelujah. Well, if you want that bread, I'm done. We're gonna get back. We're gonna pick up where we left off next week. But if you want that bread of life, Just say these words with me. Jesus, I'm a sinner. And I want to be changed from the inside out, Lord. Lord, change my heart and the way I think in the name of Jesus. Father, give me and make clear to me that what I ask you, it shall come to pass, Lord. Lord, I repent of my sins. I believe that Jesus died and resurrected for me. No, say for you, for me. And Father, he was raised again on the third day. Now, if you said those words, you're saved, brother, sister. It don't take you going and getting a carpet and laying on it and doing a lot of, you know, putting your head up, putting your head down, bring it up, standing up, go washing your hand, your face, and your feet and all that. It don't take all that. It don't take all that, you know. It takes right where you sitting there on that couch or laying in that bed. Just to say without, if you said that with me, you saved. How can you say that, preacher? Well, go to Romans chapter 10, verse 9 through 12. Now I'm going to pray. Father God, we pray for the families, for the young man here in Rantoul, Father, that got stabbed, Father, in front of his 2-year-old daughter. Father, we pray that you take the memories out of her mind, that she don't remember that part of her life, Lord. But Father, let her remember the smile that was on her father's face. Father, we pray for the young man that did it. I know you're sitting there in the county jail, beating yourself up, tearing yourself down because you made a big mistake. But young man, I'm telling you that even you can be forgiven. Get down on your knees and ask God to take the pain away. In the name of Jesus. Father, we just thank you for every man that's watching in the county jail. We pray for their families. And Father, we hope that they can request that Reverend E.V. Davis Jr. come inside the jailhouses to give a word. Father, we pray for the young lady that was at the nursing home that froze to death. We pray for her family, Mother Brooks, and all the Brooks family. We pray for them right now. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for the Chester family. We pray for Larry Chapel and all those, Father, that was acquainted with him, with Chester. Father, we ask that you bless right now, even as you can. Now, tune in next week. We'll end up talking about the bread, the ending with the bread. But tune in next week. Tell somebody about the show. Amen. And that number on your screen, you can call it, and I'll specifically get the message, and we will pray for you right on the air. God bless you. See you next time on Saving Souls and Making Disciples. God bless you real, real good. Hey, Morningstar Freewood Baptist Church, Bishop Jimmy O. Holmes is my pastor. Come on over and visit us. Come on over and visit us. 11 o'clock service on Sunday morning. Amen. Wednesday night, 7 o'clock. Come on, visit us. God bless you real, real good. 1402 Eads. God bless you real, real good. We'll talk to you next time.